our planet is dying at a rapid rate to the point where if anybody comes to you and says to you that we'll be here in 100 years, as if we would, it's impossible at what I'm witnessing. So I'm going to show you some facts. So my friend Noah is going to help me. And so we'll just go ahead. Okay, well, right now we see end time science. One of the things we do is an end time news report. And what we do is we try to show scripture with headlines that come together. And so one of the things is we have volcanoes are erupting. Right now, since this slide has been produced, there's now 40. So that is not normal. So let's go to the next one. Okay, Monsanto has eradicated milkweed. And so now the butterflies, 90% of our monarchs are gone. Okay, let's keep going. Dolphins are threatened, and because we have shorter time, I'm just going to flip through these. This is a recent information. We've got tornadoes going on, mudslides. These are new headlines that we just came up with. Large quakes in Singapore. We've had an increase of earthquakes. Let's move to the next one. Our earthquake activity has jumped up. These facts are from 11,341 in 2013 to 16,000. So we've seen a real change. We've got ecosystems, they're changing. Okay, let's just stay there for just 1 minute. I just want to mention this. Do you guys remember Jacques Cousteau?
Yeah.
Our good friend Jacques Cousteau, undersea expert. His son, John Michael, said 5 years ago, he said that fish was introduced to the coral reef and it destroyed it because it was the wrong fish. And it went in and destroyed the whole coral reef. And John Michael Cousteau said that our environment is so tenuous and so fragile and delicate that the change of the wrong fish being introduced to a coral reef can destroy it. So I want to ask you, if you see what's going on here, you take a delicate system, what is happening to our world? So think about that. Okay, let's just keep moving. Okay, millions of ash trees are dying across America. The emerald ash borer is destroying our trees. Okay, Noah? We've got no more baby orcas being born, amphibians being wiped out due to deadly disease in Spain and killing all kinds of things. Frogs, toads, newt species, okay? Seabird colonies are dying off. 1,300 bird species facing extinction, okay? We've got mass die-off of lobsters. Majority of Caribbean's reef is being wiped out by disease. You notice it's not one thing going on, okay? Songbirds are disappearing. Songbirds and birds that are like the bees. They move seeds around and populate the landscape. So it's very significant that this is happening. Bumblebees are dying in Europe. We're going to talk a little more about that. Mass scallop die off the oceans. What's killing moose? The biologists are perplexed as to why. Our dead sea, our 98% of the ocean life is showing signs of death. Chinese rivers are disappearing since 1990s. These are actual headlines that I've been pulling. 70 species of fish in danger of extinction in the Ukraine. Catastrophic collapse of Saharan wildlife, according to scientists. 300 million tons of waste in the Mediterranean Sea. We've got killer whales dying off. Okay. Unusual, okay, let's go to the next one.
Okay, and then just keep going. Sardines, shellfish are dying off. And the oceans are literally changing to a point where they're dying off. Great signs of it. One of the largest bodies of fresh water in Siberia is seriously ill and dying, okay? A white plague is destroying coral reefs in the Caribbean. We have larger dead zones than we've ever had. We had 162 in 1980, and now there are over 400, rising sharply. These are large areas of the ocean that are just completely dead. Okay? Okay, we have, this is significant. 40% of our bees have died in the United States, and the White House has declared that they're looking into it. They're making attempts to see what's going on. Well, you know, if bees die, there is no man-made mechanism that can replace the system of the honeybee and how that intricate system works. Okay, this is highly significant. 327 mass animal die-offs events of various species in 60 countries since January of 2015. And if you go back to 2014, 2013, and back, there's long lists of animal die-offs. And I just want to say this very quickly, because I got to keep moving. But remember what I just said about Jean-Michel Cousteau, that the ecosystem is very intricate. If you do one thing wrong, it can throw off the whole thing. Well, what happens when you have this happen? What, I'm asking, our world is changing right under our noses. Okay. This is brand new. This came out in May. Mysterious disease threatens Australian turtle with extinction. And one, this is wild. One-third of endangered Sega antelope mysteriously die off in a few days. Up to 85,000 antelope. This just happened in May. Okay, this is a really amazing thing that I discovered. I just sort of came on this. The USGS tracks landslide events. And between 1994 and 2004, you can go to this website, and I clicked on, and each of those years, from 1994 up to 2004, there were only one or two landslide events going on. If you click on 2014, there were over 74 landslide events in the year 2014. And in those years prior, there were only, through that whole segment, there were only one or two worldwide landslide events listed. But as recently as a year ago, and I'm not counting what's happened already this far into 2015, there were over 74 landslides in the world. Wow. Now, I stumbled across this information and I was like astounded. I thought, this is very unusual. Something is happening to our planet. And I can tell you what I believe from a spiritual standpoint, a world that rejects God and pushes God away, as we know our world has and is doing, pushes away life. When you push God away, you push life away. And when you push life away, death comes. And so now we're witnessing what a world looks like when death comes, because we do not have God and His protective hand and His life-giving source in operation. That is what is happening, and it is from our evil. We can see the evil rising up in the world, the rejection of God, and it, you know, there's a cause and effect, and that's what we're witnessing. Okay, we're going to jump over to that. We have a little clip. Okay, Noah, there's just like right over here. You can just take off that. Okay, there we go. And there's little arrows. We're gonna look at these pictures. There we go. Yeah, there it is. Okay, I just want to show you real quick, and then I'm going to bring Michael up here. I want to show you the sinkholes that are going on. The Lord gave me a dream. You can just keep flipping through them. The Lord gave me a dream, and I had a dream about a sinkhole. It was a house was falling into a sinkhole. And it was the wildest dream because after the house went into the sinkhole, these are sinkholes around the world that are going on. You can see the pictures. After I had this dream, and in the dream, I saw this house break in half, go in this hole, and then I saw these dark figures going up the side of the sinkhole. And right after that, a friend of mine in Jamaica had the same dream. She reported that she saw dark figures. And she said the Lord told her that they were portals from hell and that the enemy, the demons, were rising up out of hell through these sinkholes. But when I had the dream, I thought, what in the world, crazy dream. And then a year later, all these sinkholes started to happen around the world, you know, where houses were toppling into holes, whole buildings, cars. So these are all just recent events, you see, where buildings and cars. There was a man in Florida that fell into a sinkhole right in his own bed while he was asleep. I don't know if you recall that. They did not recover him, unfortunately. This goes back to the Bible. Do you remember the story of Korah? And Korah was punished because he had gone to Moses and Aaron and said, "Who died and made you boss?" basically. And God got very unhappy with Korah. And Korah and his whole clan were taken down into a hole and not recovered. So we're seeing a lot of this around the world. It's really stunning. I don't know if we can turn that light down, Don. There seems to be no rhyme or reason to this. They're just showing up everywhere. There's a huge hole. Here's one just in a building. Now, if you'd like to see these, just go to the link, the website, which is Sinkholes Around the World. That's all you have to enter into the search engine, Sinkholes Around the World, and it's ABC News, ABC News. And you can go through and look at these again if you'd like. Okay, I think we've seen enough. Thank you, Noah.